look like a vampire today. Okay. Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lover. Welcome back to my channel. Today, sorry for the light, but I'm doing this video after work in the evening, so it's a bit dark. But anyway, so I'm doing this video in response to a tag from my friend Fragmento. And the tag was about what was our first fragrances, the fragrances that change everything. But I didn't really understand all of it, really. So, is it the first fragrance you bought? Is it the fragrance that actually changed everything, no matter when you bought it or something like that? Is it the first fragrance I bought, my parents bought, someone bought to me? I didn't know. So I'm gonna do all of it. Anyway, so the first fragrance I remember smelling was when I was, I don't know, like really young, probably like before, between 5 and 10, because before 5 I can't remember anyway. But yeah, I remember we had those family reunion for Christmas or whatever, and we were going to my grandma's house, and then we had to share the bathroom for everyone to get ready for the party or stuff like that. And I was the only one to spend like an hour, 2 hours inside the bathroom. Everyone was complaining, like, what is she still doing in the bathroom? What is she still doing? I was just basically like getting ready. It takes time, you know. And also I was just like trying all the fragrance I could find. So my auntie was here. She had like a little vanity and I was checking what she had as a fragrance. And I remember she was having Angel from Thierry Mugler. And I remember the first time I smelled it. I was so surprised. This caramel, chocolatey kind of scent was actually really weird to me. And but I did really like it at the moment. It's something that I wouldn't wear now anymore, because for me it's something that stays in the 90s. I like to smell it, but I wouldn't like to wear it again. So yeah, I did first smell that. My grandmother used to wear a lot of like J'adore from Dior, so that I love. That's why I can't wear J'adore, because it makes me think of my granny. But yeah, and I also, anyway, I was just very curious about fragrances since I'm very young. I remember my mom had a collection of all the fragrances she had, just like me. And she had all these fragrances that are empty, and I was just like sniffing them, like, oh, oh, oh. And a lot of the fragrance that she had, I have them now, so I think I've been like kind of influenced. She was good education into my fragrance journey, I think. Oh my god, if she's hearing that, she's gonna be like yes, she had Kelly Calais, she had Terre d'Hermès. She was wearing fragrance for men just like I do, so I think he did like influence me a lot. And she was wearing, what is she was wearing? Babydoll, Yves Saint Laurent. Lots of things. But really, I was really influenced by her choices. So something very elegant, not too refreshing, quite, you know, not too strong. I mean, a good balance, that's what I think. And so the first fragrance that I personally bought was Parisienne Yves Saint Laurent when I was a teenager, just because Parisienne was really on trend at the moment, like everyone was wearing Parisienne, and I wanted to, you know, you're in high school, you wanna be like the other kids, so that's what I've done. And I did like it a lot, like everyone, like when they were crossing me, they were like, oh, it smells like Clémence or stuff like that. So I did love this fragrance and still wearing it to remind me of high school. I didn't really like my high school, but anyway. The first fragrance that someone bought to me, but it was my request since long time. It's my dad bought me a number 5, and I just That was the happiest day of my life. Since I'm really young, I'm telling, like, even before 10, I'm passionate about Gabrielle Chanel and her life. So for me, having a number 5 was like such a massive thing. I always wanted a number 5, always asking for it all the time. I was like, I want a number 5. And I had a number 5, so very, very young, actually. At the beginning, it was not my favorite smell, but the whole history behind of number 5, how is it been created, a bit by luck, you know, she had to choose a few samples. I've been reading all about that, and I was just like, oh, it's beautiful. She was such an example in my life, and she helped me to grow really, and I loved the fact that she was really independent. She fight for her rights in fashion, and also, like, she freed the woman, and she didn't need any man in her life, and that's something that I do really like. And for me, I kept that always in my mind, saying, like, you don't need anyone, you can do that yourself. I don't need a man, I don't need to be married, I don't need all of that, and I just can be myself. So yeah, that.
J'en ai satisfait.
Ah, j'en suis ravi. Évidemment, c'est ce que j'ai cherché, c'était mon but, créer un style, il n'y en avait plus. À mon sens, car il n'y a pas de style en France.
Number 5 is still my favorite, like number 5 on the toilet, number 5 everywhere. Yeah, I've got a few bottles of those and different version, different interpretation. And my signature set is number 22, that is another version of number 5. So I just, yeah, you know, like this is the smell. This is it. That's it. Well, tell me what's yours in the comment. What is the first fragrance that you bought, or someone bought to you, or maybe blah blah blah. And I think I need to tag someone. Do I need to tag 2 persons, or did you tag someone? I don't know. Well, I'm gonna tag my friend Sentita Fragrance, because I've been part of his video one day, and so if you want to have a look at his channel, I really like his channel. So that's the first name that came in my mind. Good luck.